Meta has just released their new Data Analytics Professional Certificate, challenging Google in the process. It is efficient, has exactly the right skills, including Python and SQL, for beginners to get a data analyst job. And it contains a new approach to learning data analytics that we've all been waiting for. In this video, I'll go through everything you need to know about this new certificate, and we're also going to compare this course to some other options to make sure that you're spending your time on the most useful course. And spoiler alert, this certificate is definitely worth it, but it's not always the best option and it does depend on where you're starting from. So drop a like and subscribe and let's begin our investigation. All right, so just a quick summary. This one is 5 months at 10 hours a week, but it is always a very generous estimate and you can definitely do it faster. Meta's goal with this course is to help you build in-demand skills and gain credentials to go from beginner to job ready in 5 months or less. That is a bold statement. Let's see how it holds up. The core things you'll learn is first how to collect, clean, sort, evaluate, and visualize data. So the basic data analyst tasks, very important. It also includes some analytical techniques to help you make data-driven decisions. The entire course is built on the OSEMN framework, which is a life cycle, basically the steps a data analyst will go through during their work. OSEMN stands for obtain data, scrub data, explore the data, model the data, and finally interpret our results. It's a fancy term, but in general, it's just the data analytics lifecycle. And finally, you'll also develop an understanding of data management and using data assets. When you complete the program, you'll get a certificate of completion. And another bonus is that this course was recently updated, or actually recently published, in April 2024. As data analytics is an ever-changing field, it is a good idea to use the most recent material to learn, which is definitely an advantage. All right, now let's take a look at each course one by one. The first course is called Introduction to Data Analytics, and it's 14 hours, and you'll learn how to apply the data analysis process in reality. The next course is called Data Analysis with Spreadsheets and SQL, so it's kind of a combination of using both of these tools. It is 25 hours, and then we have a Python and Data Analytics course, and this one is very interesting because Python together with SQL are the two most in-demand tools for data analysts, so having both in one course is incredibly valuable. And in this one, you'll also use a specific Python library called Pandas, which is very popular for data analytics and highly desired by employers. It offers data structures and operations that are fantastic for data manipulation and analysis, such as the Pandas data frame. In my opinion, this could be the most useful course in the program. The next one is also very important, although it's a bit more theoretical. This course is called Statistics for Marketing. And in this course, you're going to be applying your data analysis knowledge to marketing specifically. And here you'll learn the basic principles of descriptive and inferential statistics, as well as how to create basic statistical models. Many other data analyst programs forget this, so I do appreciate that they bring in statistics as a core part of their curriculum. It's still very short at only 16 hours, but will give you a lot of valuable knowledge. The final course is called Introduction to Data Management, and at the time of this recording, it has not been released yet as it's a very new program, but it shouldn't affect you when you're getting started and taking the certificate. And that brings us on to how new the certificate is. Normally, I would be worried when it's an untested program that it's pretty new and that many people haven't completed, but Meta developed a fantastic course called Marketing Analytics, and they're also a well-known company. They've made many courses in the past, and so far the reviews are very good. So I wouldn't really worry about this one. Anyway, the final course covers the basics of data collection and data quality management, how to store data, and how to work a little bit with big data as well. Finally, it also talks about data security, privacy, and data governance. Let's move on to some important things to know before you start, and then we'll compare it to some of the other top certificates for data analysts. One really important downside that I haven't figured out an answer to is the lack of a capstone project. So far, I see no capstone project in the course from the information available so far, and a capstone project is basically a final project where you put all of your skills together into one final project. It looks great in your portfolio and will teach you a lot of the practical skills directly hands-on. I'm not sure if they're planning on implementing one in this program. It's highly possible that they are planning to do so in the future because many other courses have a capstone project, but we don't know. To be honest, the capstone project is not 100% essential. There are a lot of great projects available all over the internet that you can do yourself. And the main reason why a capstone project is so good in a course is because it actually forces you to complete a full project. It is very easy to just get caught up in a lot of other things and never actually finish a project, So as long as you're able to do that, I don't think it's gonna be a problem. So if you do take this course, just make sure that you're going to also be applying what you learn to a project after you're done with the course. That is gonna be very advantageous and way more valuable than just taking the course alone. Now let's compare this one to some other certificates. The basic Google Data Analytics certificate is a fantastic option as well. It is longer and in my opinion, less practical, as it is known to be one of those courses that we spend a lot of time on theory and understanding the underlying concepts. That can be really valuable for a beginner as well. But if you do want to get some hands-on practice, I do think that Meta's course is a better option. The Google course also works with R, whereas this one uses Python, and Python is generally seen to be a better option for beginners in data science, as it is more versatile and used by more companies. But both are good options. If we compare this one to the IBM certificate, I would say that they are very similar, and the IBM course also has, you know, slight more focus on Python, but it does not cover statistics. IBM courses are also known to be a little bit rough on the edges, but still very valuable, and if you have the time, you could complete both of them to get a lot of hands-on practice. I also want to compare it to the Microsoft Power BI Data Analyst certificate, and this one is very popular right now, and it's really good if you want to learn Power BI specifically, but it is not a general data analyst certificate like this one, so they're not really comparable. And if you want to, you can start with the Meta certificate, and then if you want to specialize in Power BI later, then you can take the Power BI course as well. So as a quick summary, I warmly welcome Meta to the Data Analyst certificate game. They're really focusing on useful skills, and it is a good professional certificate overall. In my opinion, best idea is to combine this one with projects or another course focusing on specific tools for the best results. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll leave a link to the course in the description below where you can try it out for free. You don't have to sign up using my link, but I really appreciate it. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.